Hello, my friends. Welcome to Anna's Violets. Today we're talking about this wonderful, gorgeous plant, and we will talk about soil, water, light, what problems you can have with this easy growing plant. Hi everyone, I'm Anna, and on this channel we're talking about plants and gardening. So you may consider subscribing to this channel if you are into plants, if you grow many plants, or if you just start growing plants. So today we're talking about this wonderful Anthurium Adrianum Sempre. I'm going to give you a little bit of description, very short, but also some care tips. And even though this plant is a very easy growing plant, there are some tricks and some tips that you would like to know to grow this plant for many, many years. Well, first of all, you may see these plants, the flowers of these plants, even as cut flowers, and they last so long on the plants or as a cut flower, they may last for a couple of months. Can you imagine? One flower can last for a couple of months, and that's why I think people really like these plants. And of course, this plant is so gorgeous. It has this very beautiful breaks of flowers. It can be white, they can be white, they can be yellowish, greenish, you know, orange, pink, red, and even really dark, like this one, like brownish or even black. Sometimes they call it even black anthurium. And the buds, they look just like this when they just start to open up. These are very beautiful plants, and if you grow them in a bright area, you will have this plant flowering for many years, from spring to autumn. Well, as for the leaves, of course, you have noticed already the leaves are heart-shaped, very beautiful, quite thick, I would say. And the new, younger leaves will be brown, a little bit thinner from the beginning, a little bit brownish. But then when they grow and they become kind of, you know, adult leaves, they turn into green. So these are very beautiful plants, and I would definitely recommend you growing them indoors but also outdoors. If you can, you can bring them outside into the terrace, on the terrace, or grow them on the balconies, in the garden. But of course, they're not winter resistant, will not survive the winter outside, so you will need to bring them inside. Okay, let's talk about light. Well, they like to grow in a very bright area but without direct sunlight. And these plants like to grow in a very warm area. Even in winter, they like to grow, you know, in a very bright area. But in winter, you may want to give a little bit, you know, cooler area for them, because they will need about 6 weeks of rest period. As for the watering, you may water it. You can water it when the soil is dry. Don't overwater it, because the roots are prone to root rot. But also don't let the soil stay dry completely, because the leaves will be droopy, the flowers, you know, will wilt faster. So try to keep the soil a little bit moist, but not let it dry and not let it sit in wet soil. As for the soil, they are epiphytes, so they can grow, you know, attached to the trees in the nature. So this means that the soil should be really porous. So you can use some, you know, bark together with perlite, cocoa peat. As for fertilizing, you can fertilize it maybe once a month, once in 2 months maybe, because these plants don't really like to be fertilized too much. And you can use maybe half of the intensity of the fertilizer that you will find in your area. Use maybe the ones which are rich in phosphorus. So this will be the middle number on the bottle or on the package of your fertilizer. And this will stimulate the growth of the buds, the formation of the buds and flowering. And when you notice, or when you know that the pot is full of roots, this is the right time to repot your anthurium, because in this way your plant will get even bushier, will grow more babies from the base, and your plant will look, you know, fuller. And as for the propagation, you can easily propagate this plant just by dividing the plant, because as you know, we have here several plants, and I can just take the plant out of the pot, separate, divide the bush into as many plants as I will have here. If it's 4 or 5 or 2, doesn't matter, I can just easily separate. Every plant will have its own roots, and I can easily plant them in different pots. So this is a very easy growing plant. However, the light and the watering can be a little bit tricky. So if you place this plant in a very bright area, you may, you know, damage the leaves. For example, if it's a sunny area, the leaves may be damaged. However, if the light is less than the plant needs, then the flowers will not be abundant and you will not have a flower in Anthurium. So this is something that you will need to find out depending on your area where you grow. You need to notice, you need to be, you know, a little bit attentive to the plant and see in which area it grows. If it's not flowering, then maybe move it to a brighter area. Or you, if you will see that the tips of the leaves are turning brown, or if there are some other spots, stains, you know, on the leaves, then maybe it's too much light, maybe it's under the sun, and then the leaves will be burnt. Another tricky part with watering is that if you overwater, if the soil stays always wet, the roots may get rotten. If you like the video, consider clicking on like, subscribe, and I will be sharing more pictures and more updates about this plant on Facebook, Instagram, Pinterest, and of course YouTube community, so you can connect with me on all of these platforms. Stay patient about plants and see you next time.